Hey everyone, welcome back. Few weeks ago, I made a video using this oscilloscope for checking different type of network on a car, including CAN-BUS, K-LINE, and LIN-BUS. After publishing that video, some of you asked me if this oscilloscope is any good for checking the camshaft and crankshaft sensors. And of course, checking the camshaft and crankshaft sensor signal with oscilloscope is very good for diagnosing the sensors individually, or if we check them together at the very same time, it's good for checking the engine timing and of course variable valve timing system as well. So today in this video, I'm going to use this oscilloscope again to read the waveform from the crankshaft and camshaft position sensors on this engine. And because this oscilloscope is a two-channel oscilloscope, I'm going to use it at the very same time to read the waveform from those sensors. This oscilloscope is from fnirsi, and this is the model that you see right now. If you are interested to learn more about this oscilloscope, you can find the link in the video description or the first comment down below. Before starting the video, if you guys haven't subscribed the channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe. We have also many online courses that you can find the link in the video description. So first of all, I need to locate the sensors and set up the oscilloscope before starting the car. On this car, crankshaft position sensor is located at the back, but this connector that you see down here is actually for the crank sensor. So we can easily reach the crank sensor from here. You can see that I have already inserted the back probe on the crankshaft position sensor. I'm gonna put that sensor on channel one. So here's the oscilloscope probe. As I mentioned on the first video, this oscilloscope is really easy to set up. I need to grab the test probe using this one, and this is for a good ground. And this is the camshaft position sensor. The middle wire right here, this is the signal. So I'm gonna put the channel two right there. So oscilloscope is ready. I'm gonna go for a start in the car. All right, as you see, this is the waveform that we are getting. The top one, the yellow one, is from channel one, that is from the crank sensor, and the blue one is from channel two, which is from the camshaft position sensor on this car. So I'm gonna stop the waveform right there, then we can turn off the engine and analyze the waveform to see if it is any good. So the first thing that we want when we are reading a waveform from any oscilloscope is to make sure if the waveform itself actually exists. So we have the waveforms right here. We don't want any sort of abnormality on the waveform. So we have a nice square waveform on the cam sensor, and this is from the crank sensor. If oscilloscope is capable of showing us one full cycle, it means two full turns of the crankshaft is going to be really good. So this is the signature waveform to show us the top dead center. So from here to this point, we have one full turn of the crankshaft. And from here to there, we have another full turn. And when crankshaft rotates two turns, your camshaft should rotate once. So this is actually half turn of the camshaft on this engine, and this is the second half turn on this camshaft on this engine. Each square waveform on the camshaft on this engine equals to half turn, half turn, half turn. So you know that the waveform of the cam sensor based on the target wheel that we have at the end of the camshaft could be a little different. On this engine is half turn and half turn. So far we are capable of reading the full cycle. You can of course adjust the voltage for each one of them. You see this channel two, if you tap on here, you can change it to channel one, and then you can adjust the voltage so we have a taller waveform, or just using this one, we have a shorter waveform. And if you click on the channel two, you can do the same thing, all right, to make the waveform taller or shorter. And from here, you can adjust the time setting. You can adjust the time setting based on the waveform that you are getting. Right now we have this time setting to be able to read one full cycle of the engine. And of course, for checking the engine timing, you should be able to read and count the number of teeth in here. So we can zoom it. You can actually count how many teeth are between this signal of the cam sensor and the signature waveform on the crank sensor. By counting these ones, you can actually tell if engine is on the timing or not. If you go for the other ones, you can actually read this one too. You can move the channel to closer, or you can actually zoom it even more for better reading. We can also read the voltage and time using these cursors. So I have this cursor for reading the voltage. For example, if I put the V2 right here and V1 right there, we have the channel 2 right here. As you see, the voltage on the cam sensor is between almost 0 to 4.5. This is 0, 4.5. You can actually do the same thing for channel 1, for crank sensor as well. If you want to read the time setting, you can go for the vertical cursor right here. This is the time setting for one full turn on the camshaft that you can read it from here, or you can put it on the crankshaft as well. For example, from here to this point, this is actually one full cycle of the crankshaft, which is going to be two full turns. And of course, when we are trying to read the crankshaft and camshaft waveforms together for understanding if the engine timing is good or bad, we need to have a look at the workshop manual or a good known waveform to make sure if the correlation that we are getting right now is good or bad. Because workshop manual is going to tell you if the number of teeth here between this edge of the cam sensor signal and this section on the crankshaft is within the range or not. I hope this is what you wanted. Those friends who asked me for checking the engine timing, crankshaft and camshaft timing, I'm gonna make more videos using this one. Another friend wanted me to check the injector waveform to see if this oscilloscope is capable of reading the pintle hump on injector waveform. I'm gonna make another video on the injector waveform very soon. If you are interested to watch the other video that we have on the channel for using this oscilloscope on automotive network for the CAN-BUS, LIN-BUS and K-LINE, you can find the link in the video description. And if you're interested to learn more about this oscilloscope, you can find the link on the video description and the first comment down below. Please don't forget to write on the comment if you want us to try this oscilloscope on any other car, or if you want us to try any other oscilloscope. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video.